A very good morning, dear students. Let's know more about a very interesting topic which we are going to study today. So, dear children, before we start with the topic, there are a few questions for you. Have you ever lost any of your favorite things or toys? Now, this is something which comes naturally. When we own so many things, it's quite natural. We may lose some of them. There are chances, right? No. Yeah, there can be different answers for this question. Was that particular thing replaced afterwards? Whatever you lost, were you able to replace that thing afterwards? Even for that, there are chances. It might be, it might not be, right? No. So, before we start, before we know the topic for the day, we must know this thing. Everyone in this world owns something, and when we own something, there are equal chances that we may lose them as well. So why then we become so upset over losing something? Right? The question arises, when it is natural, then why do we become upset? Isn't it possible to buy another thing and be happy after losing that first thing, whatever object we have? Is it possible or not? So there are a few questions like this which come in our mind. Today we are going to study the ball poem, which is written by the greatest poet, John Berryman. So let's know more about the poet. Yeah, John Berryman was born on October 25, 1914. He was an American poet and scholar. He was born in Mathiston, Oklahoma, and he was a major figure in American poetry in the second half of the 20th century, and was considered a key figure in the confessional school of poetry. His best known work is The Dream Songs. He's famous for the collection of the poetry, the work, what he has written under this title. So let's know more about the central idea, or what we can call it as a gist of the poem. As you can see, loss is a part and parcel of human life. When we own something, as we discussed earlier, losing it comes naturally. When we own something, there are equal chances that we may lose that particular thing also. So it is said, loss is a part and parcel of human life. And the very important next point, which is written here on the board, nature of loss in this materialistic world, or as given on your screen, epistemology of the loss, to understand the nature of loss. Why we have to bear losing something. Why this loss comes in our life. What is it that it wants to teach us? Many lessons which it gets along with it. When we lose something, it's not only the sad experience, but at the same time, it makes us wise to be stronger than what we were earlier. So not only this, the ball poem, you can call it as a metaphorical or symbolical poem. So in this poem, the ball represents, or ball stands as, childhood memories. Childhood memories of the central character of the poem. So as you can read it, ball represents lost childhood memories or past days of the main character of the poem. This losing, it could also be a feeling that you have gone astray, you have lost someone, or it can be about the death of our loved one as well. So it can be taken in different ways, either losing something, a thing, an object, or a person, our near and dear ones. So few important points before we start with the poem. A boy, a small boy, who's the main character of the poem, he loses a ball. Now he's very upset because a ball doesn't cost much, or it is difficult to buy another ball. Then what is the reason? What is the reason for this boy's spoiled mood? Why then is the boy so upset when he can naturally, normally, by a new thing, we can replace the lost ball with a new one. Then what is the point? Why is that boy so upset that we want to know about this? So before, for knowing all these things, what do we need to do is, we have to read the poem and we have to find out what the poet thinks has been lost and what the poet has, what the small boy has to learn from the experience of losing something. So let's get these important points before. And yeah, we are going to study this interesting poem, okay, which is titled as The Ball Poem. So thank you everyone.